Now the last two problems of this chapter, atomic structure. The problem 9 is given as, so that the Balmer spectra lies in the visible range of electromagnetic spectrum. So the problem is the Balmer spectra lies in the visible range of electromagnetic spectrum. So this is the problem. Now to prove this, we have to find that the wavelengths that are associated with the line spectra of Balmer series must lie within the visible range. So first of all, we have to know the visible range of electromagnetic radiation. The visible range of electromagnetic radiation is between 380 nanometer and 700 nanometer. So the visible range ranges from 380 nanometer to 700 nanometer. Now this is the longer wavelength region, that is, it will correspond to low energy electromagnetic radiation. Longer wavelength means low energy electromagnetic radiation, and shorter wavelength means high energy radiation. So this extreme will correspond to the red light, and beyond that we will get infrared radiation, and this domain will correspond to the violet light, and beyond this range, that is below this wavelength, we will get ultraviolet region. Now we all know that for a photon we have, from the Planck's law, E equals to h nu, and if we put the value of nu, which is related to velocity of light, as follows, that is frequency into wavelength equals to velocity of light, then putting this value of nu here, we will have hc by lambda. So you see, the energy of a photon is inversely proportional to its wavelength. So more the wavelength, less will be the energy. So it will correspond to the red end, and it will correspond to the violet end of the spectrum. So we have this spectrum to be like this: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. Now you have to prove that the line spectra, the lines that are obtained in Balmer series, fall within this region. So that will only solve this problem. Now the Balmer series is countered theoretically by Rydberg equation, and the Rydberg equation is wave number equals to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. Now for Balmer series of hydrogen atom, only for the Balmer series of hydrogen atom we get the visible range. So we will put here hydrogen atom.
Now whether for another atom, whether it will be in the Fibonacci range, this is not the issue of this problem. We know that for hydrogen atom, the Bomar series will belong to the, will correspond to the visible range. So we will concentrate on H atom. So for H atom, the equation will be modified to be RH here. So this is the Rydberg constant for hydrogen atom. And when we talk about Bomar series, it will be N1 equals to 2 and N2 equals to 3, 4, 5, 6, and so on. So this is the Rydberg equation. Nu bar equals to R into 1 by N1 square minus 1 by N2 square. And if we concentrate on H atom only, then this Rydberg constant will be RH. And we know the value of this Rydberg constant. We can also determine the value of Rydberg constant for other atom, but at present we will concentrate on hydrogen atom only. Now this Bomar series is we have the Bomar series when this N1 is equal to 2 and N2 is any value greater than 2. So what does that imply? You see, this is the nucleus and here are the proton and the neutron. In hydrogen atom there is however no neutron, only one proton is present. Now say this is the first Bohr orbit, n equal to 1, and say this is the second Bohr orbit, n equal to 2. This is the third Bohr orbit, n equal to 3, and in this way, say it is n equal to 4, say it is n equal to 5, and so on. Now, if the electron after excitation comes to n equal to 2 from any excited state, then only it will correspond to the Bomar series. But if it comes to n equal to 1, that is the first Bohr orbit, it will correspond to Lyman series. If it comes to third orbit from any higher orbit, it will correspond to Passan series. So when we are talking about Bomar series, the electron must de-excite from any higher orbit to the second Bohr orbit. So the final destination is the second Bohr orbit, either the initial orbit, that is the starting point of the transition, maybe the third orbit, maybe the fourth orbit, maybe the fifth orbit, and so on. Now when it jumps from the third orbit to the second orbit, we will get the photon having maximum wavelength. Why? Since this energy gap is the lowest among all the possible transitions in Bomar series. Now since the energy gap is lowest and we have the relation between energy and wavelength to be inversely proportional, we will get here the longest wavelength. So the transition 3 to 2 will be associated with the longest wavelength. And you see, the next possible transition in Bomar series is from 4 to 3. And the immediate next is from 4 to 3. I have said 4 to 3, not, it is not the case. It will be 4 to 2. So the first line that will be obtained is the transition corresponding to n equal to 3 to n equal to 2. And the next one is n equal to 4 to n equal to 2. And the next one is n equal to 5 to n equal to 2 and n equal to 6 to n equal to 2. It is the fourth line. So for the transition from 6 to 2, for the transition from 6 to 2, it will give the fourth line. It is giving you the first line, It is the second line, it is the third line, it is the fourth line. And another possibility is that it comes from infinite distance. So if it comes from infinite distance, then there is another possibility. Now we have in Balmer series four lines. If this is the wave number, then we get here a red colored light, which is referred as the H alpha, and we have bluish green, which is referred as H beta, and then we have blue, which is referred as H gamma, and finally we get the violet line, which is H delta. Now in Balmer series we have four lines that fall within the visible range. One is H alpha, it is the red light, and then bluish green light, we get H beta, and the next line comes in the blue domain, it is H gamma, and it is H delta. Now see, this is the transition with the lowest possible energy, so it will be associated with the longer wavelength. So this red light will correspond to 3 to 2 transition, and this bluish green, it will correspond to 4 to 2 transition. The destination is identical for Balmer series, and for this line it will be from 5 to 2, and the last line it will be from 6 to 2. Now for the transition from 6 to 2, you see we get violet light. So it is estimated that if the transition occurs from infinite distance and it end up in the second Bohr orbit, it will give you ultraviolet light and it will not be within the visible range. So let us now check. Now it is clear that this is the longest wavelength, this red light, and for the transition 6 to 2, it will be associated with the, this 3 to 2 transition is the longest wavelength, and this 6 to 2 will be the shortest wavelength. See this energy gap between 3 and 2, it is the lowest among all transitions that are possible, and from 6 to 2, it is the highest energy gap. So more the energy, less will be the wavelength, so it will be the shortest wavelength. So it will correspond to violet light. For the 6 to 2 transition, it will correspond to violet light, and it is H delta, and it will correspond to red light, and it is referred as H alpha. So let us now prove it. Now if we check and find that for the transition 3 to 2 and for the transition 6 to 2, we get within this region 380 nanometer to 700 nanometer, then it is by default proof that the transition from 4 to 2 and 5 to 2 will remain within that domain. Since the two extremum, if the two extremum, that is 3 to 2 and 6 to 2 transitions, have wavelengths within this domain, then obviously the transition from 4 to 2 and 5 to 2 will obviously belong to this desired range. So we will prove only these two transitions, that is 6 to 2 transition and 3 to 2 transition. So let us start with this 3 to 2. Now we have nu bar equals to RH. Rydberg constant for H atom is 109678 centimeter inverse. Now it is for the transition 3 to 2, third orbit to second Bohr orbit. We put here the values. N1 will be, N1 is the target orbit. This is N2 and this is N1, and the electron is coming from this orbit to this orbit. So it will be 1 by 4, 2 square, and it will be, this is 3, so it will be 1 by 9. Now we simplify it, so it will be 9 minus 4 by 36. Now we know that nu bar equals to nu by c. Now c equals to nu into lambda, so it will be 1 by lambda. So inverse of wavelength will give you the wave number. So or we can write this to be 1 by lambda, or lambda will be 36 by 109678. This centimeter inverse will come to the denominator, so it will give us centimeter in the numerator. Now this one 9 minus 4 equal to 5 here, and we have the unit centimeter. Now come to this transition. So it is nu bar 6 to 2 equals to 109678 centimeter inverse. This is the value of the Rydberg constant for hydrogen atom, and we have this one as 1 by 2 square equal to 4, 1 by 4, and this is 6, so it is 1 by 36. Now 1 by lambda, nu bar is 1 by lambda, so it is 109678 centimeter inverse into the LCM is 36, so it is 9 minus 1 by 36. Okay, or lambda equals to 36 by 109678 into 8, and it is centimeter. Now let us calculate the values. It is 36 divided by 109678, and again we divide it by 5, so it is 6.5646, this one we ignore, into 10 to the power minus 5 centimeter. Now we multiply this one by 1000, so we have to divide this one by 1000 again, so it will give us 6564, since we are multiplying it by 1000, and so we have to divide it by 1000. So 10 minus 5 by 1000, it is 10 minus 8 centimeter, so it is 6564 angstrom. Now what this value is? This value is 36 divided by 109678 equals to, again we divide it by 8, so it will be 4.1029, so we again ignore the fourth term after decimal, into 10 to the minus 5 centimeter, so it will be, as per the previous procedure, it will be this 4102 angstrom. Now I have told you that this will correspond to the longest wavelength and this will correspond to the shortest wavelength. So this is the red light, so lambda 3 to 2 transition, that is lambda red, is given by 6564 angstrom. Now we know that 1 nanometer equals to 10 to the power minus 9 meter equals to 10 to the power minus 7 centimeter. Now we multiply it by 10 and divide it by 10, so it will be like this, 10 into 10 minus 8 centimeter, so it is 10 angstrom. So 10 angstrom is 1 nanometer, so it will be 656.4 nanometer. Now for this shortest wavelength, that is having high energy, that is 6 to 2 transition, that is for the violet light, it will be 4102 angstrom equal to 410.2 nanometer. 410.2 nanometer. Now we know that the visible range of electromagnetic radiation is 380 nanometer and 700 nanometer. That is the visible spectrum ranges between 380 nanometer and 700 nanometer. And we see the two extreme transitions associated with the Bamar series, that is from 3 to 2 and from 6 to 2, lies within this range. This 410, it is above 380, and this 656.4, it is below 700 nanometer. So it guarantees that the Bamar series, the Bamar spectra, lies in the visible range of the electromagnetic spectrum. So the first problem is solved. Now the next problem, problem 10, it is so that electron cannot reside within the nucleus but within the atom. This is a beautiful problem, and to solve this you must know the uncertainty principle. Now the Heisenberg uncertainty principle can prove that electron cannot reside within the nucleus but it can reside within the atom. So what does it imply? This is nucleus and this is atom. Now the electron is not allowed to reside within the nucleus but within this atom. So only this extra nuclear part is available to electron. And you see, if this problem is solved and if you are able to prove this, then you can support Bohr's theory, which tells you that electrons move around the nucleus in definite orbits, and obviously it does not reside within the nucleus, it remain within the extranuclear part. So for this you need the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. So that is given by del x del p greater than equals to h cross by 2. So this is the uncertainty in measurement associated with the location of the electron, and this is the uncertainty in measurement associated with the location of the uncertainty in position associated with the location of the electron, and this is the uncertainty with the momentum, that is the error that is encrypted while measuring the momentum. So the product of these two have a minimum value h cross by 2. Now for doing the math, we will use only the equality, that is we ignore the greater than sign and we put the value of h cross, which is h by 2 pi, so it will be h by 4 pi. H cross is h by 2 pi and 2 here, so it will be h by 4 pi. Now you see the diameter of atom and the diameter of nucleus is of the order, this atom is of the order of angstrom, 1 angstrom, of the order of. So, in centimeter it will be 10 to minus 8 centimeter. Now, the diameter of an atom is of the order of 10 to minus 8 centimeter. And we know from the scattering of alpha particles by Goldfein, the pioneering experiment that was established by Rutherford, that nucleus is almost 1 lakh times smaller than that of the atom. The nucleus is almost 1 lakh times smaller than that of atom. So what will be the diameter of nucleus? The diameter of nucleus will be then 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter by 10 to the power 5. So it will be 10 to the power minus 13 centimeter. And if we convert it to meter, it will be 10 to the minus 15 meter. Now, if we consider that electron reside within the nucleus, first we consider this. Let us assume. Let us assume that electron resides within the nucleus. Then what will happen? If it resides within the nucleus, then the uncertainty in measurement of its location will be 10 to the power minus 15 meter, since you cannot locate it to be within a dot. You cannot locate an electron precisely. So it will, if it is within the nucleus, if the electron resides within the nucleus, then the uncertainty in measurement that will be associated with the location, with the position of electron, that will be 10 to minus 15 meter, that is the diameter of the nucleus. So if we put this in this equation, Heisenberg uncertainty principle, we will get del p equals to h by 4 pi into del x. Now this del p equals to m del v into h by 4 pi del x. Now this is or, not 9, or del v equals to h by, now h is 6.626 into 10 to the power minus 34 joule second by, it is 4 into pi, so it is 22 by 7, I take it to the numerator, and we have m here. If we take this to the right hand side, it will be m here. So we have 4 into 22, and this del x is given by 10 to the power minus 15 meter, and we will have the mass of the electron, which is, it is mass of the electron, so it will be 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg. Now it is 7 into 6.626 by 4 into 22, it is 88 into 9.11. Take the power in one side, so it is minus 31. When it come here, come to the numerator, it will be plus 31, so it will be minus 3. And when this minus 15 comes here, it will be plus 15, so it will be 10 to the power 12. So it is 10 to the power 12. Now about the unit, joule is newton meter, so it will be kilogram meter per second square into meter into second. Joule is newton meter, so kilogram meter per second square into meter, and this one is second, and we have meter here and kg here. So this kg kg and meter meter will cancel, and this second and second to the power minus 2, it will be minus 1. so it is meter per second. So that must be, since it is the velocity, or del V equals to, now let us calculate this part, which is 7 into 6.626 equal to divided by 88 equal to divided by 9.11 equals to. So it is 0.0578. 0.0578. It is 0.0578 into 10 to the power 12. It is meter per second. So it will be 5.78 into 10 to the power 10 meter per second. We take 100 out of this 10 to the power 12 and multiply here. So we will get 5.78 into 10 to the power 10 meter per second. Now see, uncertainty in velocity is 10 to the power 10 meter per second. What is the speed of light? It is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. It is 3 into 10 to the power 8 meter per second. Now you got the uncertainty, which is much greater than speed of light. In the previous lecture, I have shown you that the uncertainty that is associated with the measurement, that the accuracy which is associated with any measurement must not cross its original value. It may be 1%, 2%, 3%, or maybe 10%, 50% say, but how can it cross the original value? Now this uncertainty proves that the actual velocity is around this one or greater than this. And what is this value? If the original velocity is like this or greater than this, it is much greater than velocity of light. Is it possible? An electron have non-zero rest mass. Non-zero rest mass. That is, it has mass. When we take electron, a particle which has non-zero rest mass, that is, it is heavier than photon, it cannot move faster than light. A particle having mass cannot move faster than light, since for photon, the rest mass is zero. So this is embarrassing situation, that we got uncertainty in velocity greater than velocity of light. So this is unacceptable. Now what led to this embarrassing result? We have assumed that electron resides within the nucleus. So if this is embarrassing, if this is unacceptable, if this is not possible, then this is not possible. So it in turn proved that electron cannot reside within the nucleus. So you have to write the things at the last, and you must say that it is unacceptable. So electron, what we have assumed is wrong, that an electron cannot reside within the nucleus. Now, can electron reside within the atom? Let us check. So let us assume that electron resides within atom. So when it is atom, we have 10 to minus 8 centimeter to be the uncertainty in location. Electron may be anywhere between this space. So it will be 10 to the power minus 10 meter. So we correct this, 10 to the minus 10 meter. Now we put here, it will be 10 to the minus 10 meter. So this minus 31, when it will come here, it will be minus 3. And this minus 10, when it will go up, it will be plus 10. So it will be plus 7. 10 minus 3, it is plus 7. And we take 10 to the power 2 from this value. So it will be 10 to the power 5. Now this value you see, this value, that is 5.78 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second, is much less than the velocity of light. So that may be the uncertainty of velocity associated with the electron. So electron can reside within the atom but not within the nucleus. So it is a conclusion, it is a beautiful conclusion from the
Heisenberg uncertainty principle.